I'm Lauren Ball. I'm an illustrator, and I want to show you some of the tips I use when I'm trying to capture a likeness of someone, either in illustration or if I'm just doing a portrait. Remember, when you're learning to draw the human head, and you break it down in that square, and you kind of divide it in half, and you divide. So all these dividing lines and where things go, those are, it's the average placement for features. And it's great when you're making it up. When you're trying to capture somebody's likeness, it can get in your way. If you're really focused on, this has got to be exactly halfway or exactly one-third, this particular character that you're drawing, things vary. So, I'm going to use Patrick Stewart as an example because his features are so distinct, and that makes it very easy or easier to capture the likeness of someone when their features are distinct like that. Let me just dive in. And I'm using this photo of Patrick Stewart, Jean-Luc Picard from Star Trek, because I love the shape of his head is just wonderful. You can see so much of the skull underneath. But when I first look at something, the first impression that I see is this area. It just stands out. And in fact, if you look at it, you go, half of all the features are down here. But all of this, if I were wanting to emphasize that, I would make that a little bit bigger. Some of the things that make him so interesting, and I've just got this on a light table, so that I can sketch on this piece of paper to show you the main things. There are these concave areas that are interesting in his features. That cheek right here, his cheek. But these angles are so, they define, they help define his character. Another thing that stands out is, depending on the light and you're watching the show, sometimes this part of his head will seem very pointed. Almost. So, so that is something I would emphasize, or at least want to capture. So, with some of those main feelings in place, the main measurement that you're going for is you're looking at dividing this space in half. And normally that's the eye level where you're That seems pretty close. And you would look at. Hmm. look at that placement. And there's another, when you're trying to capture his likeness, this area is very interesting. The bridge of his nose is pretty wide. And if you also look at that center line, the width of that, of his nose, is a defining characteristic. And this angle of the nostrils, another thing that is unique for him is that when he's not talking, that mouth is straight, and that lower lip is there's another little concave cut right there. And so I'm just pointing out the areas. I don't sit there and trace. In this instance. And here's something else. I look for carry through lines. That underneath the eyelid and the eyebrow, those kind of, I can carry through some of that. And if I turn the light box off, you'll notice this doesn't read as Patrick Stewart. But those are the elements that I would be focusing on. So with that in mind, I would take this and just use it as a reference and grab a new piece of paper. But with those ideas in mind, the first thing I'm looking for is going to be that center line, the width, cutting it in half. And when you're trying to decide how wide do you make it in relation to, and in this case, you would say that from the center line, what can I compare it to? And in this case, it's the width of the jaw. Right here, it's close, just a little beyond. If I can get that area from here, I know that area at about the jaw would be and there's a little bit of a slope. Now, there's that space where the eyebrows are. To talk and draw at the same time. Anyway, focusing on those landmarks, I'm looking at this area of his That center line, it's about where these cheekbones are, at about their most extreme point, is just a little below that. And so there's a little bit here, but that scoop of his temple. And then there's so to get that general shape of the head, that's what I'm going for. And in his skull, you can see this, the temple area is so I don't know, pronounced would be the word. And with this particular photograph, if his head were looking directly at the camera, the brow line typically lines up at the top of the ears and the bottom of the nose. But if your head is tipped, you're going to notice that the ears are above, and they are in this photograph. So if that's the brow line, I know that the top of the ear is slightly higher than where I would typically want to put it. And the other measurement that you're looking for, you've got that center, and if you divide that, the center line, because when you're capturing the likeness and you're learning to draw the figure, you're learning these divisions for the average. But when you are trying to capture a likeness, it's how do things diverge from that average? Are they more pronounced, longer, shorter? So in this case, normally that distance between the eyes and the chin, if you were to divide that in half, it would give you, or actually in thirds, if you divide that in thirds, it'll give you where the lip is placed, the bottom of the nose, and this chin area. And so, from here to the bottom of the nose, it just doesn't fit. It just doesn't fit. So, I end up just eyeballing it. I'm looking at that, and it feels like this. And it feels like this. The lip feels like this. And this. Shapes. I'm looking for is... start focusing on the shape of the shadows. Thank you. even though this isn't an exact likeness at this point, it's not a bad start. And if I were to glance over at this, I'd have to tell, oh, Jean-Luc. I'd have a good idea of who I was working on. At this point, it's focusing on the shadow shapes. The more accurately you can capture the shape of the shadows, get the gist. And that's it. Those are the tips that I use when I'm trying to capture a likeness. And if I'm struggling and it's not close, I just need to step back a little bit and focus on identifying what those unique features are that I'm trying to capture. Trying to isolate and emphasize those slightly will help. If you found this helpful, I hope you'll like the video and subscribe to my channel. I'll be sharing resources and inspiration and tutorials that have helped me as an illustrator and hopefully will help you. Thanks for watching.